Hey, isn't it awesome when a train goes roaring past? Wow, that train must be flying! Did you ever wonder just how fast that train is going? Wait. Before we talk about speed, maybe we should know what we're talking about. We usually measure speed in miles per hour, or mph. That's how far you can travel in 1 hour. The more miles per hour, the faster your speed. It's like this. When you're traveling in your bus to school, you might be going about 30 miles per hour. That means it would take you 1 hour to drive straight from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania to Trenton, New Jersey. When you're in the family car on the highway, you're going about 60 miles an hour. That means it would take you 1 hour to drive straight from Denver, Colorado to Colorado Springs, Colorado. So, now that we know what speed is, we can talk trains. Here, look at this. When the locomotive was first invented way back in the 1820s, a steam engine called the Tom Thumb carried passengers at a speed of about 12 miles per hour. By the 1850s, passenger trains were going almost 25 miles per hour. By 1900, trains moved at nearly 50 miles per hour. Today, it's important to make sure everyone on the train and around the tracks is safe. So trains have speed limits, just like cars on the streets and highways. In America, freight trains can't go any faster than 80 mph, and trains with passengers can't go any faster than 90 miles per hour. Usually, when you're waiting at a railroad crossing, the trains are going about 40 or 50 miles an hour. In other parts of the world, some trains run on special magnetic tracks called maglev. At times, they can travel at speeds as fast as 370 mph. Wow, that's crazy! Well, now you have some idea of just how fast the trains you see are going. Remember, be safe. When you see tracks, think trains. So long!